In this tutorial, we will demonstrate how to georeference an imported HECRAS model to a river alignment. Here, we see a river model in HECRAS. It's a simple, straight-line model. Notice that the cursor coordinates displayed on the bottom right are not relative to any state plane coordinate system. In fact, this whole HECRAS model is less than 1 foot long. Switching over to GeoHECRAS, the first thing we do is add a background base map. To do that, we'll right-click on the Map Data Layers panel and select Add Basemap Layer from the displayed context menu. This will bring up the Add Basemap Layer dialog box, allowing us to select the basemap to display. Although this is a personal preference, we're going to use the hybrid map from Microsoft Bing. This is a decent map with good aerial photography and labeling, but the choice of basemap is up to you. Click OK to close the dialog box. Next, we'll need to select the map coordinate system that corresponds to the map coordinate system that the HECRAS model was defined with. To do this, we're going to select the File ribbon menu, and then click on the Map Coordinates menu item. From the displayed Map Coordinates backstage page, we can browse the continents, countries, and states to select the map coordinate reference system that we want. However, an easier way to select a map coordinate reference system is to use the search function. Since our project is located in North Carolina, we can simply type in North Carolina into the search field, and the software will display only those coordinate systems that are in North Carolina. From the displayed listing, we can see the different map coordinate reference systems that correspond to North Carolina. The coordinate system we want is the NAD83 North Carolina in feet. After clicking on that coordinate system entry, we can see a preview of the coordinate system bounds in the map preview window. To select the coordinate system, click on the Apply button. We can see that the software has automatically cropped the Microsoft Bing map to the map coordinate reference system limits. The software has also reprojected the map to the selected coordinate system projection. This particular project is located in Godwin, North Carolina. To find this city, right-click on the Map Data Layers panel and select Zoom To. This brings up a dialog box where we can enter this location, Godwin, North Carolina, and click on Go. GeoHECRAS will search for that location on the internet. Let's double-click on the first item, and we'll zoom us into Godwin. Our particular project is a little further east, right here. What we want to do at this point is digitize the river alignment for this project according to where the HECRAS model is located. The first option is to go to the Watershed ribbon menu, and then select FEMA Flood Data. This will bring up the FEMA Flood Data dialog box. You can specify which FEMA flood map options that you want to display, but the default settings are fine. Let's click OK. Now the software will automatically stream the FEMA flood data onto our computer, overlaying the map view. From within the FEMA flood data, we can see the river alignment line. Also, we can see that a map legend was downloaded for us to utilize. Now we're ready to digitize our alignment. To do so, let's start by going to the GIS Edit ribbon menu. From here, select the Draw Polylines menu item, and choose the Draw Curvy Linear Polyline command from the drop-down menu. Next, we can digitize the alignment centerline for the river by clicking along the river like so. Zooming in helps significantly with this process, and you can do so by using the mouse scroll wheel. Now, if you make a mistake, don't worry. You can right-click while digitizing and select Undo Last Point from the displayed context menu, or simply just hit the backspace key on the keyboard to undo the last digitized point. Once we're done digitizing the river alignment center line, right-click and select Done. Just like that, the river alignment center line is created. To save time, we've previously digitized this river alignment center line. Now that we've done that, we can turn off the FEMA flood data as well as the Microsoft Bing map, revealing just the river alignment centerline. Next, we're going to import the HECRAS model to align with this river. To do this, go to the Input Ribbon menu and choose Import Data. From the drop-down menu, select Import HECRAS Project to import the HECRAS model. From the Import dialog box, we can select the HECRAS model to import. Click on Import, and the software will import the HECRAS model. Now you can see that our model is in real-world coordinates. However, it isn't the coordinate reference system that our previous data was in. To fix this, we're going to return to the project site by right-clicking on the Alignment Centerline layer from the Map Data Layer panel and select Zoom to Layer Extents. Next, click on the HECRAS layer in the Map Data Layers panel and drag it onto the map view and place it alongside the river alignment. Now we can see that the HECRAS model is in the same coordinate space as the digitized polyline, which represents the river alignment. Next, we want to georeference the HECRAS river reach to the alignment polyline. Let's start by turning on the base map layer. You'll notice this small tick mark that we placed on the line, just as a reminder of where to start. To georeference the river reach, select River Reaches from the Input Ribbon menu, and select the Georeference River Reaches command. This will bring up the Georeference River Reaches dialog box. From here, select the option Snap to Alignment Centerline. Next, we want to pick near the downstream end of the river reach. Click on the Pick button, and the software temporarily hides the dialog box and prompts us to select the alignment reference point on the map view. We can zoom in and click on the alignment polyline. You can now see where we clicked is represented by a small red dot. And the software has also highlighted the selected alignment line. Now we want to do the same thing for the upstream end of the river reach. We'll click on the Pick button again and make our way to the other end of the model, where we'll click again to create this point. Once this is done, the dialog box will reappear. Now I should point out that it is not necessary to click on both alignment points. We could have simply selected either the downstream or upstream alignment point, and the software would have figured out what it needed to do. Anyways, click on the Snap button, and the software will align the HECRAS River Reach with the selected alignment polyline. Next, click on the Close button to close the dialog box. Now, looking at the model, we see that the river alignment is not quite where it needs to be. For instance, this bridge at Interstate I-95 is represented by this gray line on our HECRAS model, but clearly, the bridge is further downstream where it is located in HECRAS. So, we'll have to move this bridge to where it's supposed to be located. To do this, we'll have to slide the entire HECRAS model downstream to align the bridge with the correct location. We can check this by double-clicking on the bridge to display the bridge editor. We see that the bridge is indeed the Interstate I-95 bridge. You can also see the bridge structure displayed in the bridge plot. Now, the next thing we need to do is return to the River Reaches menu and select the Georeference River Reaches command again. This time, we're going to select the Slide Along Alignment Centerline option and then click on the Slide button. We can see on the map view this highlighted line which represents the river reach atop of the river alignment polyline we created earlier. Now simply click the yellow line and drag it along the alignment centerline. And we can see on this yellow line the bridge structure location, which is represented by these two brown dots, which represent the bounding cross sections, and this green dot that represents the bridge structure. We want to slide these dots with the bridge structure on the map view. Once we've aligned the bridge, right-click and select Done from the displayed context menu. And just like that, GeoHECRAS will align the HECRAS river reach and bridge structure to the selected location. Click on the Close button to close the dialog box. The bridge structure is now correctly aligned, but we still have some issues. Some of the cross sections need to be aligned. To do this, we'll turn on the FEMA flood data layer. Also, In order to better see things on the map view, we'll click on the Preferences button for the Bing map layer and change the transparency level. Making the map more transparent in order to make the FEMA base flood elevation contour lines more observable. This will help us in aligning the cross-sections relative to them. Let's start with this cross-section right here. Right-click on it and choose Graphic Edit. This places a bounding box around the cross-section. The cross-section needs to be rotated to be aligned parallel with the FEMA base flood elevation contour. This green diamond is the cross-section rotation anchor point, which we'll click on and drag over the thalwig. Next, we'll click on this yellow dot representing the rotation handle, and drag to rotate the cross-section so that it lays parallel to the adjacent base flood elevation contour. Now that this cross-section is correctly aligned, it's on to the next one. We can see that this cross-section should follow along this contour line here, and then bend here. To align this cross-section, we'll go to the Cross-Sections menu and select the Georeference Cross-Sections command. From the Display dialog box, click on the Draw button. We can then draw on the map view where the cross-section should go. It's not necessary to draw in where the entire cross-section needs to go. Rather, just draw where the alignment has this bend. The software, with its understanding that the cross-section thalwig must continue to match the same spot, we'll do the rest of the alignment work. We'll draw the line parallel to the bend, then right-click and select Done. And we can see that the cross-section is now properly aligned, bend and all. Aligning all of these cross-sections can be a tedious yet simple process, and doing so will properly align the HECRAS model with the actual map. And with that, your HECRAS model has been georeferenced.